The date, January 2015. The location, Swansea town site deep in the Arizona mining country. Around this very campfire, we discussed the thought of attempting what would turn out to be one of the greatest and most challenging trails of our lives. Happy to get up there and really test our rigs out and get out on the trail. The sticks and the stones that you used to throw have built me an empire, so don't even try.
Wow, look at that. The screamer, the rough rider, the rib.
The French freedom tickler.
I like it. Only in Northern Nevada.
After a 9-hour drive, we enjoyed a much needed meal while meeting up with Chris and his wife, who drove in from Utah, adding to our eventual 6-rig crew. A good night's rest was then in order, preparing us for an adventure in the morning that we would never forget. Jen and Chema would join us the next morning, rounding out the group and setting the stage to take on the mighty Rubicon. Cut off my wings and come lock me up. Just pull the plug, yeah, I've had enough. Tear me to pieces, sell me for parts. You're all vampires, so here you can have my heart.
About to put a dent in my truck, or maybe several.
Nice.
But I'm gonna be smiling when I'm doing it. There's a funeral, a room of ghosts. No hint of movement, no sign of pulse. Only an echo, just skin and bone. They kick the chair, but we have to live. Oh God!
In a word, the Rubicon was unrelenting. Stacking rocks, spotting over boulders, and being covered in dust would be the trend of the day. You must have made some kind of mistake. I asked for death, but instead I'm awake. The devil told me no room for cheats. Despite the extreme demands of the Rubicon, we were forced to stop and take in the beauty that surrounded us.
Just about 13 hours, and we haven't even reached our first camp yet, so needless to say, the Rubicon Trail definitely lives up to its legacy for sure. So, we're a little tired, a little hungry, a little bit of damage on our rigs, but other than that, you don't have to
We would end up completing one of the most challenging sections of the Rubicon under complete darkness. After nearly 14 relentless hours, we finally ended up at Rubicon Springs, where the group would set up camp, enjoy time by the fire, and we would discuss our plan of attack for the second leg of the trail in the morning. I think it's time to pack it in. Don't call it.